Dear students, here I am going to give you the answer of the questions which I have already uploaded in the YouTube from the units and dimension. I think units and dimension I have given very rare questions. Okay, we'll solve you later on also. So look at this, the answer for the 1, 2, 3. I think it's very simple for 4. In the question number 14, you can see how we have solved this. You can check. Is it right for the answer? Here what happens is the angle has no dimension, so always it will give you 1. So you can take this angle as 1. Is it right? So T dimension here downward, in the denominator also T dimension for T. It will give you 1, so it's a correct. But here it is, if I'll take the angle VT, where V is L by T and T cancel, so it will L will left. It is not correct because there is no dimension, so it will give you 1. Here also you can check, you know, it's also TT cancel, correct. This is not correct, so I think answer 3 and 2 is right because they both are incorrect. In the question number 15, I think you know how to solve this one. Is it right? There are so many observations are there. Yes. So you can see 1.328, 1.330, 1.32 and 1.326, 1.334, 1.336 are the observations. Is it right? Means your experimental value, suppose. So first you do one thing, right? I have taken these all observations mean. So mean I got it here. Is it right? I got the mean value is 1.3298, 1.330. This is the real value. Is it right? Keep it in mind. Mean of the observation will give you the always real value. So these are the answer. And if I'll make them difference, so I think you will get the absolute value. Yes. Because this is the real value, all are real. Real minus experimental will give you the absolute. But in all the absolutes, right, again you have to take the mean. So mean is 004. So look at here, sorry, mean is, mean is not 00. Yeah, mean of the absolute is equal to 004. Is it clear? So that's why here, after that you can see, so mean of all the absolutes will give you the mean absolute. The mean absolute is this 004, and here it is 004 divided, this is relative value, and if you multiply with 100 it will give the percentage, 0.3% it is. Clear? So these are the answers. So you can match it, right? Now come to back to the next video uploaded on the topic of motion in a straight line. I think questions you know well. Let me go with the answers only here. Here you know that this is a graph, so how we find in the graph, the question was to find the displacement. So area of the graph between V and T will always give you the displacement. So you know this is positive, this is also positive, but this portion is negative. So I have here minus, and that is a right triangle, so half into base into height we have done, and 3 I got it. It's very simple, clear? If you come with the question number 2, is it right? In the question number 2 it was written that a rocket is fired vertically up from the ground with an acceleration of this. The fuel is finished in 1 minute and the rocket again moves up, right? It's a very, there are two parts. When the rocket is moving up, definitely initial is zero with the acceleration. Is it clear? And in 1 minute he reached some of the point, right? So let me find the displacement. S is equal to ut plus half of at square. If I'll apply, definitely a is your 10. देखो आंसर मिल जाएगा 1800, राइट? एंड सिमिलरली फ्रॉम दैट सेकंड पार्ट, दैट इज फ्रॉम देयर टू व्हेन द फ्यूल इज फिनिश, अगेन ही इज मूविंग इन द सेम एक्सीलेशन, बट ही विल रीच द फाइनल वेलोसिटी विल बी जीरो. सो इफ आई यूज दिस, इज इट राइट, वी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, यू 600 एंड 2a. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज हाउ विल फाइंड दिस इनिशियल. दिस इनिशियल इज एक्चुअली द पॉइंट ऑफ दिस वी. तो लेट मी फर्स्ट फाइंड द वी फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट पोर्शन. देखो मैंने यहाँ पे फर्स्ट पोर्शन से 600 फाइंड किया, अब ये 600 हो जाएगा सेकंड पोर्शन का इनिशियल हो जाएगा. सो इन दिस वे आई विल गेट द S2. So this is the value of your S2, and if I'll add both, I will get the 36,000, which is 36 kilometers. In the question number 3, just look at here. Question number 3 is very interesting. When elevator is moving, after that you release one. I think it's you have released one what ball or something. I forgot this. A ball is written, but with the help of velocity is 4 meters per second, but angle of the 30, is it right? This here it is written elevations, right? Angle of elevation from there is 30, means this is the angle. So here keep it in mind always, dear, that whenever a ball is moving downward in direction, definitely this is a part of the projectile, because projectile mein aayega wo. Isliye maine yahan pe dekho, I have used here the projectile, that time of flight of the projectile motion to you this, right? But the question is here the g. So look at here, already lift is moving with the acceleration of 2. So when it is coming downward, definitely g 10 to use karenge, but ye 2 ko kya karenge, is it right? So since the body is also moving downward with the 2, is it right? But due to the opposite directions I have used here, to yani ki 10 plus 2 to 12 to yahi pe ho gaya. So keep it in mind always, we have to add this and get the answer. Yani ki 10 ye g ka ho gaya, plus 12. So use it here, and theta and rest all are given to you, is it right? In the question number 4, is it right? In the question number 4, look at here. The question is the two objects along with the same straight line path, is it right? So one of the object, suppose ye hai, jiska speed 2 hai, because when one will cross the 2, definitely his speed should be greater. So 2u, he is the 2u, and a and u and 2a, okay? Now if I'll use this s displacement, and let me take the displacement is 0. Displacement 0 means initial position. At the initial position, definitely I will use the resultant one, because displacement 0 matlab in dono ke distance ke beech mein, to in between the two means there is a relative velocity will come, and 0. Let me place 0 here, and look at here, u displacement, maine relative lagaya. Similarly, acceleration will be also come in the relative position, is it right? And you got the time is this. Now let me use the displacement as covered by the first body. So definitely abhi to speed and acceleration will come for the first body. So look at here, s is equal to u2 plus half of it is square. I will use here, is it right? So look at here, this in ut, this is u and t, and this is half of at is square, is it right? In place of 2u, I have written if the second first body cover kar raha hai, to uska speed aa jayega, and acceleration also I have written here a only, you can see, is it right? In the question number 5, you can see a juggler is maintains 4 ball, right? So main kaam karta hu, pehle ek ball ka nikal leta hu. So let me find the one ball. S is equal to ut plus half of at square. There is no doubt of this, hai na? So when I got time is 2, to ball ko niche aane mein fir se 2 lagega. Total time is equal to 4 seconds. So 4 seconds mein 4 ball ko maintain kaise karenge? 1 second ka interval hoga isme. Simple si baat hai. Thank you. Two particles A and B are right thrown in the directions. Is it clear? You can see this. So concept मैंने ये लगाया इसमें कि ये ball अगर आते आते x distance करेगा तो ये जाते जाते कितना होगा 20 minus x हो जाएगा. तो यहाँ पे मैंने वही use किया, x का इस्तेमाल किया, और यहाँ पे मैंने 20 minus x. After that जो x का value है वो यहाँ से उठा के यहाँ डाल देंगे. Initial velocity 5, iska initial 20. I think you can use it here. T is the time. Dekho, in dono cases mein ek cheez hai ki T is the time kyun dono ka match kar raha hai. Ki at the same time they will collide. Now solve it. Dekho answer kaise nikalta hai. In the question number 7 is really easy hai. Right? Bullet is in the jeep. So definitely इन दोनों का स्पीड ऐड हो जाएगा. ऐड किया, 5/18 है ना वो किलोमीटर पर आवर को कन्वर्ट करने के लिए, इज इट राइट? फिर जीप और बुलेट इस थीफ को पकड़ेगा या उसको हिट करेगा, तो डेफिनेटली रिलेटिव आ गया. तो रिलेटिव में माइनस आ गया सेम डायरेक्शन की वजह से। यू ट्राई, यहाँ पे भी तुमको 5/18 लेना है बिकॉज मीटर पर सेकंड में कन्वर्ट करना है। सो आई गॉट इट 150 मीटर पर सेकंड। इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट लगता है, लेकिन है नहीं वो डिफिकल्ट। देखो, एन ऑब्जेक्ट ड्रॉप कर रहा है टॉप ऑफ द टावर। तो हमने क्या किया, फर्स्ट हमने ये देखा कि एक्स डिस्टेंस है ना, एक्स डिस्टेंस में फर्स्ट सेकंड में, तो 1 यहाँ लगा लिया, एक्स निकल गया। ये फिर बोल रहा है 7x इन द लास्ट सेकंड, तो लास्ट सेकंड में भी तो उसका एक ही सेकंड लगता है। खैर जो भी हो, लेकिन ये 7x इन द लास्ट सेकंड बोल रहा है, तो यानी कि SNNth आ गया। तो SNNth का इस्तेमाल करके ये n जो है वो टोटल टाइम दिखाता है, यू नो वेल। तो फिर यहाँ से n 4 सेकंड, यानी कि टोटल टाइम हो गया, मिल गया। अब s इज इक्वल टू u2, यानी कि टोटल मेरे को पाथ निकालना है, तो s इज इक्वल टू u2 प्लस हाफ ऑफ 80 इसको लगा लेते हैं। बस समझ में आ रहा है, टोटल टाइम मिल गया, इस तरह से 80 मीटर वो आ रहा है। क्वेश्चन पढ़ने के बाद ही तुम आंसर देने की कोशिश करो, देखना। इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 भी बहुत इजी है। देखो, एक स्टोन बैलून, जब एक बैलून ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा था तब स्टोन को थ्रो किया गया है। फिर से वही देखो, जी का इस्तेमाल मैंने ऐड कर लिया, 10 + 1.25 = 11.25। तो एक काम करते हैं, एस निकाल लेते हैं। आई गॉट माई एस बिकॉज हियर आई थिंक द टाइम इज ऑल्सो गिवन आफ्टर 8 सेकेंड, सो डेफिनेटली आई हैव यूज्ड हियर 8 एंड आई गॉट द आंसर इज 40 मीटर। तो मैंने क्या किया, तो 40 मीटर में स्टोन, डेफिनेटली स्टोन का भी 40 मीटर ही होगा, तो 40 मीटर में टाइम 2.66 आता है। तो अगर मैं ऑप्शन में जाऊँ या 4 सेकेंड तो मैच नहीं कर रहे, तो डेफिनेटली द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज द बेस्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 में देखो, वेलोसिटी बाय टाइम नहीं है, डिस्टेंस है। तो अगर एक ऑब्जेक्ट ऊपर से गिरेगा तो डेफिनेटली उसका स्पीड तो इंक्रीज होगा एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट विल आल्सो इंक्रीज। वेयर दिस ऑप्शन इज इंडिकेट दैट व्हेन द स्पीड इज टू मच हाई, दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट विल कॉन्स्टेंट रिमेन, वो हो ही नहीं सकता। हेयर ऑल्सो इम्पॉसिबल, दोनों मैच नहीं कर रहा। सो बेटर आई कैन से दिस वन, एंड हेयर इट इज़ अ टोटली ऑपोजिट, दिस इज ओके। ओके, इन द 11 सी, ये तो बहुत आसान है। फर्स्ट एक काम करते हैं इसमें, राइट, फर्स्ट यू फाइंड इट फॉर द टी सेकेंड। तो टी सेकेंड में देखो, हमने ये निकाला एच हाइट है, इट्स गिवन हियर एच हाइट, दिस इज एच हाइट, एंड टी बाई थ्री में निकालना है। सो एट द टी बाई थ्री में मैंने क्या किया, फिर से वही निकाला, द वैल्यू ऑफ हियर टी आई गॉट इट फ्रॉम हियर, यहाँ पर डाल दिया, तो मैंने एच में नहीं निकाला। तो बहुत आसान है, ये तुम कर लो। Okay, student, then thank you. And if any problem, you can send it, right, the question.